going to test 5 different CD-ROM players. Nowadays, the performance of a CD-ROM player is of little interest to the modding and overclocking community. All those fancy graphs and numbers, who needs them anyway? It's a CD-ROM, it plays CDs, so what? As a matter of fact, the reviews are boring and we don't understand the words they use anyway. Today we're going to test the stuff that really matters. Water resistance, pressure proof, overvoltage resistance, fat tolerance, sub-zero cooling, and shock resistance. All those peeps with water cooling will tell you, once you test it and install the damn cooling, something will go wrong and hose your entire system. The CD-ROM player must therefore be water resistant.
Normaal kunnen ze met de twee lopen uit.
Ja, is zo onder de nerf.
Nou, eigenlijk niet dichter met de taal, maar ze gaan het ook niet slapper.
Deze is nu. This one works.
This one's fucked.
Yes, you will be excited when your new toys arrive. No, you will not be patient and put your inventory neatly organized on the table. Yes, you're a lazy dumbass. Your room is a mess and you put everything on the floor. In the excitement, you'll probably trample on something when constructing your PC. The CD-ROM must therefore be pressure proof. For the next test, you definitely need your neighbor's Porsche.
Oops, this one's broken.
It will be late. The place is definitely ill-lit. You will have drunk way too much El Cheapo beer. You're extremely tired. You only have to plug in the easiest part of the computer, the CD-ROM player. Your level of attention hits rock bottom. You're bound to make a mistake. You're going to plug it in the wrong way. The CD-ROM must therefore be overvoltage tolerant. To test the overvoltage of the CD-ROM player, we're going to plug it in 220 volts instead of 12 volts. Let's see how it works out.
Oh, man.
Ich höre es nicht.
Funky.
Favorite foods are the ones that can be eaten in front of the screen. pizza, French fries. All the grease will get on your hands and you're just too damn lazy to clean the shit off whilst manipulating the player. The CD-ROM will get smothered and must therefore still be working, even when things eventually grow out of the player. We therefore need fat resistance. Apparently, the CD-ROM players are more tolerant than our test person. This is the era of extreme cooling. EVA units, Promethea, liquid nitrogen. It's fashionable nowadays to freeze your CPU. The CD-ROM must therefore guarantee you perfect working condition, even while deep frozen. What we need is sub-zero resistance. This one seems fucked. It's fucked. When going to a LAN party, while staggering around drunk in your room, the case and thus the CD-ROM player will take a couple of blows. The CD-ROM must therefore be shock resistant.
Oh, fucking believable!
The result is that only 2 CD-ROM players passed our extreme tests. Players 1 and 18 did. Damn shame that we can't read the brand anymore, and we can't remember where we bought them. Anyhow, I hope you enjoyed our tests and stay tuned. In next week's episode, we'll show you how we extreme tested some GeForce 4 graphic cards.